Hello everyone, here are some of the new and most useful features in Resolve 16. Just a heads up, the studio version kept crashing on me, so I installed the light version on a new system and I'll be using Blackmagic's official clips for the studio features. We now have completely new cut page designed for what Blackmagic says are quick edits for fast turnarounds. On the top where we have the media pool, you can quickly switch between media, transitions, titles and effects tabs. Cut page features so-called dual timeline where you have an overview of the whole timeline on top and you have a bigger zoomed in version on the majority of the screen. This way you can easily take one clip from the bigger view and replace it in the timeline by using the small view on top. Resolve 16 now offers per timeline settings for formats, frame rates, monitoring and output sizes, instead of before where you had to choose these settings for the whole project. You can also easily edit these whenever you want. We now have a built-in notepad in the project to quickly write some notes. Back to the cut page, it also features smart insert button. You can easily insert clips to the cut point nearest to your playhead, and Resolve will automatically adjust other clips after the insert point. The same goes for append button and ripple override button, where they append clips to the end of the timeline or replace one clip with a different clip in the middle of the timeline, saving you precious seconds when editing. You can also use the close-up button to quickly duplicate a clip on the track above it and set the scale to 200%. And finally, you can quickly add a new selected clip above the main track with the Add on Top button. Similar to the edit page from Resolve 15, you can also import your footage straight to the cut page, instead of using the media page first. Thanks to the new DaVinci Neural Engine, you can now quickly scan the clips for people's faces, group the clips for different people, which you can then use to easily find shots with specific actors. Resolve 16 finally features smart time remapping by using the Neural Engine. You can easily retime your clips and choose the new Smart Speed Warp to slow down your clip significantly. Long-awaited adjustment layer or clip can now be added to timelines and used to apply multiple effects to multiple clips. Open effects can also be added to adjustment clips, which was previously only the case in the color page. The edit page now has a stabilization effect, which can greatly help improve some accidental shaky clips in your timeline. There are also new curve editors for Resolve and open effects you have on your clips, easily accessible and editable. In the color page, we can now enable the histogram to be shown below the curve adjustment, and we can also choose to show the histogram before or after the selected node. And finally, the long-awaited simple copying and pasting of grades is here. You can now easily copy from one node and paste attributes to the other node, selectively choosing what to paste. We can now open the timeline and select the in and out points and loop those sections only, instead of a single clip loop like before. The video scopes are now much better looking and much more detailed thanks to GPU acceleration. There's also a low pass filter which removes the noise from the scopes to better see what matters. The parades now include YRGB and YCBCR modes, similar to the new modes of the waveform monitor. You can now look at the highlights, midtones and shadows individually in the vector scope. You can also manually define the boundaries of each. The CIE 9031XY scope can show you your colors and tell you if they fall in the gamut you're working in. We can now easily search for location of the selected LUT in the LUT browser. The face refinement tool now has beauty mode, which can help you easily and automatically beauty up your actors without too much manual adjustments. You can now view individual red, green and blue channels to look for any noise or artifacts, very useful for denoising your shots. You can now quickly toggle off the navigation bar in case you're on a laptop and you need some extra real estate on your screen. And the best for last, you can now quickly and easily remove objects from your scenes by using the new object removal tool. And that's about it. Leave a like and subscribe if you liked the video. Thanks for watching and goodbye.